next week, next recycle will be collection. So you, a bit like Adam's job, bit where you hire a bin, that increases our recycling, recycling measure for what we need to be. So that's just an idea that comes to my head. The other issue, I've worked with another organisation where there is no paper, and it's a product on a mark called Board Pad. So all minutes, agendas, everything go on the Board Pad. You do that. And finally, where are we in terms of energy to waste in the hierarchy? Because it's my belief that a lot of our stuff ends up being used in an energy to waste plant. If that moves up the hierarchy, then we can meet our recycling targets fairly rapidly. So that's the
project. Just briefly, the issue about party bins, perhaps where we're looking at the moment is clearly around the times of the year, Christmas in particular, where there's obviously pressure on capacity. And we don't want, I mean, there also is a huge downturn in contamination and quality of site at the same time. So clearly, to maximise our recycling performance, we want to try and address those issues and give people the best opportunity when there are those being born. So that's that issue. In terms of energy waste is lower down on the hierarchy. The best one, in terms of waste hierarchy, the best is obviously waste minimisation and reuse, recycling. So in terms of energy from waste, I'll just have a question, Steve. Where is the disposal of energy from waste?
If energy from waste was considered to be now a safe industry and what have you, if we, I think a lot of our stuff would go without water, it goes into a huge plant and is then to produce electricity.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just trying to look at, if the legislation is moving towards that, then we need to consider.
I mean, the legislation,
we need to go back to.
The legislation is clear that the opportunity to just bring it into efficient energy from waste plants and reuse is not people that way. We need to keep working at curbside collection. Brexit obviously has made a legislation ambiguous. What is ambiguous is the English target for recycling is 50% by 2022.
You could probably talk or even definitely miss the line, but it's an important principle, that waste hierarchy the council of fact refers to. So the positive is that we are getting waste away from landfill and we're getting energy from it by sending it to the new plant on Teesside. And that plant will be coming on, there's been some teething problems, but we'll be coming online shortly. But the important thing is, even though we've pulled waste from the very bottom of the hierarchy, it would still be the intention, if we can, that if we can get waste from energy from waste up the hierarchy again, so that it's recycled, for example, food waste, that's clearly where we want to be. So the more we can move any of our waste up that hierarchy, the better.
Thank you, Chair. I think that's the last question. So just in closing, I want to say there's a lot of good stuff that's going on at Containers Report. A lot of it's got very little to do with being that only to confirm the post. And that being the case, I just want to also give credit to the officers on Burnley who came before me for it. And hopefully I'll keep doing it and reiterate them when they'll contact me before I do a lot of this. And that's it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much. Quick thank Phil.
Aspect of the attractive local environment pledge. Important meeting.
set by 2020. We've seen already that we're flatlining the land machine around about 36%, so we know that we need to get, I think, like around about 16,000 tons out of that residual stream, 16,000-17,000 tons out of that residual stream, and actually start recycling that. You'll remember that we came to Cabinet last summer with an outline business case around that, and essentially there were two key principles that we talked about there. The first is that industry best practice is saying that if you want to achieve those recycling targets, you need to be looking at two things. The first one is that getting on to 40% by weight of the household bin is actually food waste. So really we want to see when it starts to recycle and do something about food waste. And secondly, to achieve the behaviour change, the authorities that we've been talking to have been saying in some way you need to constrain residual capacity, and you either do that by less frequent collections or smaller bins. So from that, we've been working on the development of a full business case, actually spending time looking at how you would do food waste, but then particularly, and we did a major consultation exercise around this, what really were the public and residents' views around constrained that residual capacity, what were the views around moving to less frequent, three weekly collections, or actually giving people a smaller bin. So we've been pressing ahead with that work, but then in the meantime, as we've touched on already, the city region leaders have realised that we spend a lot of money as a city region, a good £100 million a year, across the Waste Disposal Authority and across all the districts in managing our waste, in collecting and disposing of waste every year. So last year, they commissioned a review. The key terms of reference for the review were, first of all, to look at how could districts and the Waste Disposal Authority, the Cycling Authority, work together, work collaboratively. What are the opportunities there to, first of all, save money, very importantly, mindful that, you know, the sums of money that we spend in this area. Secondly, how we could do that to maintain a quality standards of service. And then thirdly, mindful of the ongoing city region devolution agenda, other ways of improving the governance of how we manage the collection and disposal of waste. And then also, leaders are very keen to look at the whole funding aspect. Many of you will be aware that we have a levy that works to a particular formula, and leaders are very keen that we actually get behind that levy and our levy of any improvements to how that issue is managed. The work was given to consultants, local partnerships, who have got a lot of experience of work in this area. They've been pressing ahead with that, and importantly, their work is coming to a close, and we're hoping that we're going to get publication of their work within a matter of weeks, Chair. So we are expecting that to come out very shortly. It's important because, as Mike touched on before, the nature of it means that in terms of what we're looking at locally on the Wirral, there could well be some significant potential opportunities, and that city region work may influence what we do and how we do things on the Wirral. So we're very, very keen. We're mindful that there's been a bit of a time delay, but we're very keen to see the outcome of that city region work to make sure that we've got a full picture of all the issues and factors in this area. We will then be in a position to conclude our full business case work. I think we've heard, Chair, from an officer point of view, that, you know, relatively quickly, late summer, early autumn, we'd be in a position to then make recommendations.
be submitted at the same time as the Foulkes case recommendation. So there was a conclusion to that consultation, which we've used to form a decision and recommendation to Cabinet.
So is that available for councillors to cannot be circulated, the consultation results?
That information is readily available. I guess the issue for me is we've done a consultation to ask for views, and it's then about what we do with that consultation feedback and how we feed it into the council's way forward and position. So that's certainly information we've got and we can share. I'll be honest, in terms of the time scales we're working on, in terms of the fact that we've done a major consultation, it's like we're acutely aware as officers that there's an outstanding question there from the communities and residents. They haven't heard anything since we went out to that consultation. I'm very hopeful that this city region review will be published shortly, and we're going to be in a position to quickly report back to Cabinet and the Council with a way forward, which will include all the detailed information from the consultation feedback, and importantly, the Council's response to it.
Can I add that? It's a really important question. Do I understand that it's a regional way of coming back upon our current case reviews? It could make it more efficient, cheaper in a number of ways. If we publish something and went forward with something that was expensive, then it could be that cost could be reduced if it was released on a regional footprint. You'd rightly hold us before you and ask why the money's being spent on it doesn't need to be for the same effect. So really, everything balances on when this regional review is going to come forward, and it will be published in the next few weeks. When that is published, we're more than happy if Chair wants to invite us to come into a presentation to committee on all that contains.
Just to clarify, I'm not asking for the proposal, I'm asking for just the results of the consultation. So what came back from the members of the public? What was the feedback and the analysis of that, not what happened after that?
Through you, Chair, we'll make that information available. Clearly, the reticences, importantly, when we consult and people give us their views, it's really important that we communicate what we've actually done with the feedback. So, you know, we can provide some information, but as I say, most importantly from the council's point of view, I suggest, is ideally to be giving that whole scale feedback to people as to what they told us, but then to actually tell people what we're going to do about it. But I think there's no reason why we can certainly make that headline information available to the committee. No problem with that.
Well, my point here, it's rather a sad one really, because during a recent by-election I was involved in a party that was previously proud record on recycling and environmental issues, blatantly gave misinformation during the election campaign, basically tried to conscript. So whatever warning officers and politicians are like, whatever you come up with, there will be political parties who will try and make gain from it and deliberately misinform people prior to any further progress. It's sadly, but that was actually the case in point. However, I still believe in the good nature of our people, and I would like a scheme that when we introduce it, the cabinet member who I congratulate as well listens, that a volunteer is worth 10 press people. Is an old saying, and I think if we can develop a scheme where people say, yeah, I'm up for this, I've heard the case, I'm up for this and I want X, Y and Z service, it's far better than people who will be told